Alright, alright, alright. Welcome back, and in today's video, we are going to be visiting a weapon that may just end up being the meta with Beyond Light's release. We really don't know, but I haven't used the Sunshot yet with the Catalyst, because foolishly, when I made my video 5 months ago, I didn't have it.
Oops.
And even if you check the history books of Destiny 2 itself, you can clearly see that it says Beyond Light meta. Sunshot. Okay, I didn't make this up. This is official. So pretty much if you didn't know, Sunshot is going to be the only 150 RPM hand cannon left. All the other current 150s, which are the meta on PC, are going to be moved into the 140 RPM category. And so I wanted to find out if Sunshot is actually going to be a legitimately very good option at the 150 RPM slot. And because I haven't used it with the Catalyst before, now is the most relevant time to do so. So maybe you're new to Destiny or you're just a PvP imbecile such as I and you don't know how this thing works. The only thing you really need to focus on is Sunblast, which makes it so that every single time you kill someone with this, they're going to explode. And then the Catalyst, which increases both range and stability. And this video is brought to you by the Ridge Wallet. It's light, sleek, and it fits perfectly in your pocket. And there's no more huge bulge that you're carrying around with one of your older leather wallets. I don't know about you, but I'm one of those people that just keeps every receipt, every single piece of paper, and my wallet ends up looking like this. Just for a size comparison, this is a direct comparison between my old wallet and my new Ridge wallet. It can hold up to 12 cards plus room for cash. There's over 30 colors and styles, including carbon fiber and burnt titanium. I like mine, but if you want to look at other people's feedback, you can just check out one of their 30,000 five-star reviews. So get 10% off today with free worldwide shipping and returns by going to ridge.com/sird and using code sird. But thank you once again to Ridge, and let's return to the video. And with all that being said, we are once again going to shoot for 10,000 likes and hop into a game of PvP.
All right. I just woke up and my voice is nearly gone. Woo!
Come on.
Good morning.
Yoink. Another one, please. All right, come back.
Got the best hip fire in the game. Don't even underestimate me.
Bro, pick it up. No.
All right, super time.
It's just God tier, man. You just don't really see anyone else in the scene doing stuff like that. No?
Bro.
What are you doing, little guy? No, bro. This game is ass. I'm going behind enemy lines for this one.
What's good, y'all?
Bro, you just pushed me, bro. Frickin' Stevicus! He just pushed me forward, dude.
Oh my god.
Dude, that's historic. Historic because I finally got more than one kill in a row.
I can explain.
No, not today. They already got beat. We were getting triple cap for a brief moment. It is kind of cool that you can really zone people out just with spamming. I mean, it's honestly not amazing, but it is useful to some degree. Triple capped once again.
Rocket launch.
Bro, I got the kill themselves with the bubble. Dude, you've got a freaking Froglin Guillotine? I get a bubble down for 1 second. I get this temporary relief from the eternal pain that is this Crucible match. Literally getting triple capped the whole time, and I immediately get right-clicked by a falling guillotine. Oh, yeah, it worked!
Bollocks.
What if I killed my teammate? Would I get, like, a new one? Like, maybe one that doesn't suck ass? He's shooting shotgun pellets at the wall, guys. All right, boys, we did our best.
It's just been, it's been a long fight, and I just had to have a warrior spirit, and that's all, so I'm just...
Baby Hammer Boy has returned. See, now that I'm running Sunbreaker with the Sunshot, like, my energies are totally aligned, like, they're really synced up. So I think that should definitely boost my performance quite a bit.
Watch out, watch
You always have to jump with grenade launcher, people. It's as so you get like the first two shots in for guaranteed damage, then you just gotta jump. Ballet time. I'm gonna swing from the ballet. Fuck. No, bro, I was gonna try to get above of the melee him. Bro, someone die. Wait, what?
Get out of my face! Get out!
He was so close to an escape, but then he realized he was jumping literally into the roof. Alright, so now I'm doing countdown because honestly, it's so good to just change it up every once in a while. Just doing control over and over. You know, no one likes that. No one wants that. Especially when you have to consider I'm a 9-time world champion in Counter-Strike Global Offensive as well. It just becomes a no-brainer, you know? Okay, this is awful. Okay. No, I needed the no-scope melee. I'm gonna go hardcore.
Hello there.
Hey, dude, look at that damage, man. The single digis? Oh my God, this gun's so overpowered. He tried to turn around. Blanked his shotgun shot and he said, retreat, fall back to the keep. I feel like this is a better game look for trying to put in that work. Oh, they're all dead.
Stop my ball!
He just put their grave down. Oh no. He just put that grave down. Now he's just fucking busting that shit down on the grave too. Honestly, we do be kind of dominating right now. Bro, what are you doing? We are dominating right now, dude.
Make like a tree and fuck off.
Oh my, what the f- What? That goofy little fella hit that? That was immaculate. The old turn your back to the enemy and revive strategy. I love that one, that's such a good one. What is this human Roomba doing? Run into a wall? Oh, bounce, hit the wall, turn the other way, and run with my shotgun. Yeah, so far it's pretty good. It's not amazing. And if you were to compare this right now to like a current spare rations, obviously the spare rations is going to be better, most likely. But the whole point is like 150s right now are a lot better than 140s. So if this is going to be the only... So once Beyond Light hits, and this is the only 150, then it definitely has more of a chance at becoming like a standout weapon, right? Because essentially every other... Oh, bro, where are you running? There's no way. Don't let me kill you with this awful super. I hit him with a full Rotundra and he still doesn't die?
It's not realistic. It's just not realistic.
No, bro! I perfectly predicted it. Just the execution was a bit bad. Last Guardian left. Oh wait, we lost?
Oh my God!
I got it, boys. Oh shit! The timer honestly did not sound aggressive at all. I didn't think it was about to explode. Bro, did he just start blinded him? Did he start shooting? Okay, wait till I take that trade.
And I
no, I put up that little peewee barrier. Yep. I'll blind him. He won't even know what's going on. He won't even know where to look. Bro, God damn it. Getting teabagged by this goofy idiot as well. Wait. What? I'm out already? Man, the sheer disrespect. All right, so I'm finishing off in a Rumble because I feel like I want to see if I can at least have one Rumble game where I'm just gunning everything. Nope, not today, Bob. Not today, Robert. Kind of like this, I guess. He's not expecting it. Oh shit! Where'd you go, little Matthew? Hey, a trade. That rift is not saving you from my rocket launcher, kid. Yeah, you're not running away, Bob or Robert. It's kind of weird. The main thing that I've noticed is that, and this could just be maybe my aim's bad today or something, but It really struggles when it's getting flinched. Like, you can definitely get on a huge roll and just annihilate people and get that recoil down when you're shooting at people that aren't flinching you back really hard. When you're getting flinched really hard with this weapon, it is very difficult, in my opinion, to still control that recoil and be killing people. That's like the number one difficult thing. Wait, what is he? Hello? Please? Yeah, this Rebel game sure is going well. I'm really dominating. I think they're all just frozen in my presence, dude. Frozen in fear, paralyzed. Oh my god, is game over? All right, so that is it for today's video. One thing I wanted to say is that I don't know how much I'll be uploading before Beyond Light. We haven't had a new season since June, and at this point, I'm not too sure if there are many things that I would even want to record. And when I'm recording, I try to be high energy, and to be high energy and have it be authentic, like, I have to actually be somewhat excited about what I'm using. So I may have consistent uploads leading up to Beyond Light. I'm going to try to come up with video ideas for that, but if I don't, then that's why. Thank you so much for watching. Click on the bell if you don't want to miss a video. Click on the like button to help support this video, and hopefully I'll catch you in my next one. Peace.